the accent or some shit? Oh, live from the South Side.
Starting already.
Nigga.
Here we go.
See, that's your problem, dog.
Here we go, dog.
That's your problem, whatever.
Yeah, wicked with it.
You can put the mic wherever you want it.
I was letting him know for...
Hey, look, don't explain your spiciness, bro.
Dog, it's, see, that's your problem.
Don't explain your spiciness, bro.
That's your problem. We know who in the cabinet.
Jesus Christmas.
Man, I want to apologize for cooking the shit out of my guest today. I'm going to just keep it real with y'all. The AC is fucking broke.
It's crazy.
It's normally a cool 68, 67 in this bitch.
It's about 85.
Literally. So we got the fans cooking up a tornado with just heat, but we going to make it through for y'all. You know what I mean?
Satan is definitely in the other room.
I believe he's real.
That nigga is right behind the camera. Shit's crazy.
He is staring at us.
Hey, look, I was about to be like, hey, look, bro. They fixing that shit tomorrow.
Right, we can shoot tomorrow.
We need to shoot tomorrow. The fuck is going on?
No, on God. Man, if I ain't have another video shoot tomorrow, I would.
Fuck it, we here now?
We here now, right. That's all that matter. Yeah. We here to give y'all something y'all ain't never had before. And on that note, I go by the name of Truth Teller Young Skills. That extremely hot ass king all the way over to my left is Trooper.
Pause.
What?
You not hot?
Dog.
He said his hot ass.
I didn't even feel comfortable saying that to another man.
That hot king over there.
And you can put the mic wherever you want it.
Dog, see, that's your problem.
Oh my God.
See, the heat is getting to you. The heat is fucking with your thoughts.
No.
Like I was saying, people, you know how this go.
That's true, bro. You.
Nigga, you the only one in here with a whole sweatsuit on. You should be.
I'm cooking, but that's not the point. The people don't know. You can't feel how hot it is in here, but I'm doing this for y'all, and it's for a purpose. That's all that matter. As long as it's for a purpose, that's all that matter. The king you see in the back, that is Deuce holding us down, you dig? Know. And we have a special guest here, people. The one, the only, Tone Calion. And how you feeling, my nigga?
I'm feeling good.
Yes, that's good. People, that was Deuce. I'm keeping that. I want you to see how Deuce acts. That part is in. That was another take. I know it looks like studio magic, but see how late Deuce be sometimes? Yeah. Like I was asking you, my brother, how are you feeling, my brother?
I'm feeling good. Feeling blessed, man.
You got to get a little closer to the mic.
Okay, say less.
I was going to say, just cut his mic up. Pause. See? Look, we ain't going there.
We ain't going there.
I'm not doing this with y'all today.
Bro.
We gonna have to figure out something.
Yeah, for these niggas, right? For these niggas, because it's these niggas, dog. It's always
it's
these niggas.
Definitely not.
I'm glad you're feeling blessed and highly favored. And people, look, before we get into the shits, for real, I know a lot of you guys, on a more serious note, some of you guys are still reaching out to get on the show, get on the episode. Look, my thing is we're not deterring that. Please still go through whatever channels you feel you have to go through. Talk to whoever you need to talk to. Still reach out. But honestly, more than just saying, hey, Skills, hey, Trooper, whoever you're reaching out to get on the show, is about your support. Do you support the movement at all? You know what I mean? Because I know you want to get on here. You want to talk your shit. And I know you got a lot of shit to pop. Whoever you might be, him or her, is not a specific person. But just make sure that we can physically see your support. We don't see your support. What makes you honestly feel like we should go that extra mile for you? Not saying that we won't, but, you know, one hand washes the other. That's all I'm saying, people.
And for you artists trying to get on here, music artists, look, got to have a portfolio, man.
Yes.
Got to have a portfolio.
Mandatory.
That's important.
You know what I'm saying? So, real life. I'm telling you, it's a couple motherfuckers that's trying to get on here that, you know what I'm saying? And these would be great guests, but it's like, bro.
What?
Do you have a music portfolio?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. And so, you don't have to have a million accolades. I know some people are still grinding and they're shaking the right hands and in their process. You know what I mean? But what has been put together to date? You know what I mean? Can you come in and name where your actual music is being heard? Do you know your stream count? Are you with ASCAP, BMI? It's just the little things. How serious are you with your career? You know what I mean? Just think about that ASCAP type of shit. You got to have something, you know what I mean? I'm not saying you got to be a millionaire or whatever, but I'm just have something that we can even talk about, you know what I mean? Because other than you coming up here, kicking your shit for 30 seconds, what more do you add? Think about those things. Just think about that, you know?
And so what they do, send a message, DM the podcast.
Yep, DM the IG.
DM the IG, y'all.
Live from the South Side Podcast.
Live. Yeah. Live from the South Side Podcast, not DMV Trooper Podcast, okay? Because I'm sick of you niggas in my motherfucking DMs asking to be on this motherfucking podcast, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to y'all. You know what I'm saying? Y'all
facts,
niggas.
Facts.
But send that message. You know what I'm saying? Send that portfolio, and there it is.
And we'll talk. We have a special guest in the building. We're going to get into the shits. We're going to talk to him because I really am excited. As you can see, I'm head to toe U.S., you know what I mean? So it's like, that's just how it is, you know what I mean? So,
let's see.
Hey, man, I love to be in it. That's what it is. Mm-hmm. But people, you need to understand that for our area, it's levels to business, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So when I say I'm excited to be sitting here with this guy right here, I'm genuinely excited because
it's a fact.
We get a chance in real time to see what someone is actually becoming, you know what I mean? So you see those before him, you see the roles that they took, you hear about the stories and all the ups and downs and yada yada, and in real time we can actually see a movement actually moving.
Hello.
And it may happen in your area with some people, but in this area, and we call it the DMV, and it's a lot bigger than the DMV, but I'm gonna just keep it here for these couple of seconds. But in this area, this is actually a brand that you're moving. And some people, watch this. When I talk about the sixth degree of separation, check me out what I mean this. Show this video to six people in your immediate circle. I can guarantee you one of those six people have seen this logo.
Mm-hmm.
That's how deep it is. You know what I mean? So, brother, I'm glad you're here today. I'm extremely psyched. Thank you for coming, first and foremost.
You know what I
mean?
This means the most, man.
You know what, bro? You said you ain't want to keep it. We was just going to keep it in the DMV for a second. Mm-hmm. I'm going to keep it in the DMV because we all went to school together.
Yes, right. Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Definitely. We all,
yes, sir.
Except for Baby Bop in the back, we all went to school
right,
together.
Right, he knew.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? And it's like, again, a couple of episodes ago, I was giving these niggas they flowers.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Talking about the progression. And looking at where niggas started from to where niggas is at now.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? My bro, he started off making videos. Now this nigga's making movies. Lil bro, you know what I'm saying? I pulled him aboard. He's been down with this podcast since day one.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and has never strayed away or, you know what I'm saying, nothing.
Right.
Now he's graphic designing, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Making videos
shit. Shiny to holler at you.
Shit that he never would have done. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Had it, you know what I'm saying, not been for this podcast. You see
right.
what I'm saying? Me, I used to rap, you know what I'm saying? And now I'm a podcaster.
You're right.
You feel me? I'm like, fuck that rap shit. I love podcasting now just as much as I love rapping.
I mean, it's still an expression.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And so, you know, you being a Suitland alumni, nigga, I'm proud as shit to see where the fuck you done came.
I appreciate you, man.
I mean, to see how far you came. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
just like he said, nigga, you show this video to 6 months or however the fuck you put it, somebody going to see that motherfucking logo.
Right.
Somebody going to see that logo. And that stands for us, never them.
It stands for United Society.
Our slogan is
us, never them.
Oh, okay. So, it was something that was us, never them. I knew
I wasn't 100%
right,
wrong.
It's 50%.
Yeah,
I take 50%. That ain't no
you
nothing.
There. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, almost don't count.
Nigga, look, one time, we asked a nigga, a nigga we had on here, about the podcast, about him watching it. He was like, yeah, I be watching that joint, man. I especially like the joint with Gillian Wallow on there. Whole time, that's a part of the fucking intro and plays for maybe 4 seconds of every fucking episode.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so it's like, damn, homes, you ain't got...
Right.
You feel me?
Yeah.
So like, real shit, bro. The love is definitely genuine.
Nah, definitely,
you know what I'm saying? Coming from this area, bro.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate it. Hell yeah, it definitely is, though. I definitely feel it, too.
Real live, nigga. I've seen motherfucking videos on YouTube, motherfuckers I don't even know, rocking your shit.
Like shit, though.
Hold on. I'm going to tell you one. I'm going to up you one on that. I seen, and you fact check it, because I want you to see it just like I saw it. It was a person on the fucking news being interviewed, and I saw this fucking logo
Hello.
On
oh,
the
yeah.
girl on the news
Hello.
Being interviewed. So yeah. I mean, come on, that's nationwide. You know what I mean? Yeah, so that's a passes YouTube at that point.
That definitely was lit. Somebody had brought that to our attention. And that shit,
real shit.
Yeah, that's dope as fuck, bro. That's like it's levels to. Like I said at first, it's levels to it, and that right there is next level. You know what I mean? Okay, so when you start thinking about your clothing brand and when you start putting your merchandise out there, think about the impact that you would feel if you turned on Fox 5, ABC News, and saw your merchandise. Hello. On that channel. Just think about that. Yeah. You know what I mean? And think about how many other people are actually watching that now see your brand that never knew or knew about it and that's excited for you. Think about those things. That's people. True. That's levels.
Let's take a pause. You know, I'm going to go back and.
Dude said pause, we pausing.
What's wrong? It seems like something's bothering you.
Lost my job. Company went bankrupt. Didn't tell us.
We left off at a critical point, and it was just giving flowers. And the point that I stressed while we was taking our short break was, niggas, you need to give people around you their flowers now. If you got somebody doing a business, why you can't fuck with their shit? If you got a nigga that's rapping, why you can't bump his music just as loud as your favorite people?
It's crazy. Just like supporting your own men, be like, they call it dick riding.
Dick riding. And I don't look.
I'm just trying to support my man.
And I'm going
to
keep it real with you. Look. My thing is, I see you got something that's moving and shit. I'm on a spot with it. Like, hey, give me that.
With it.
Let me get that. What else you got? Nah, let me fuck with. Let me get some more of that. Let me get. You ain't got no more? All right, let's meet up. Now, I'm with that. And can't nobody say I'm not. You see what I mean? So I support in every way, every shape, every form. And I believe that you got to pay that shit forward. You know what I mean? That's the only way brands like this and other brands in your area get popping and shit. You wonder why my man can't take off, man. He just as hot as Sean John or just as big as Emma. Why he can't? Because you not supporting him.
Right.
Just think about that shit. You know what I mean?
Well, I just want to say I ain't know the nigga was coming. So I couldn't cop nothing. You dig?
But it's on the way.
But it's on the way.
Right. And I got the website, so it's nothing, you know?
Okay. Yeah, there it is, man.
Tell them the website real quick.
It's usnevertheim.com.
One more time.
It's usnevertheim.com. usnevertheim.com.
Hey, so Tone, let me ask you this. In your opinion, what is the number one problem with being a fashion designer?
The number... trying to come up with new designs.
Tell me.
That's definitely a... an obstacle in itself.
Oh, man.
You know what I'm saying? For sure.
Trying to keep that shit original.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And trying to be, you know, new and relevant, not trying to look like the next person, trying to...
Exactly.
Hey, you know
you got to stand out.
Exactly.
So how do you keep it fresh? Because everything I see always look new, is always something popping. How do you
work? I honestly don't know. I just try to be outside and get... I just try to be outside and try to just come up with new ideas, but I don't know how it happened.
Like I said, I woke up like this, nigga. What are you talking about, nigga? It's just how I am.
Hey, it's real nigga activities going on in here, man.
I swear to God.
I don't know shit.
It just happens, man.
Let the people know who are you, what you about real quick, and then we're going to get into this interview because I got some questions I want to ask you.
Okay. How you doing, people? I'm Tom McCallie. Y'all don't fuck with me or fuck with me. I mean, I've been doing this shit for a long time. I've used to rap. Now I'm motherfucking transitioning to doing clothes and shit. I've been a fashion nigga for a long time, so now I just want to, you know, dress the city and see how it's going to come out.
Okay.
Oh, yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
The white folks, he's a fashion designer, not just a fashion nigga.
There you go. Okay. Right. Yeah, I had to clean it up. Right. I'm a fashion designer.
There you go.
I like that.
And I will be referring to you as one today, not a fashion nigga. You know, right. I mean, I know it's levels and shit, but you a fashion
fuck that,
designer.
Man, he
today.
A fashion right. nigga, man.
Yeah.
One of the flyest ones out here, man.
All right.
I just told you it's real nigga activities going on.
It
man,
is.
You know?
It
and
is.
We're not going to act like we don't know this nigga, man.
Exactly. Okay? Exactly.
We all went to school together, minus Baby Bop. Okay?
You got a minus Baby Bop.
Okay.
A lot of years.
I remember when this nigga was fucking niggas up, beating his feet in the hallway.
Nah, man.
Telling them the truth. Telling them the truth. Telling them the truth.
Okay?
Yeah, what they know about it.
I'm talking about fucking niggas up.
Yeah.
I've seen it.
Yeah, I seen it too.
Okay?
I seen him on stage do it one time.
Come on, man.
Fucked him up on stage.
Yeah, I was there. I was definitely there.
Killed him.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? So
That was a time too.
Yeah, like, that was a time to be alive.
You know what I'm saying? Just transition that talent to something else.
That's how you gotta do it. You gotta reinvent.
Exactly.
See, the progression.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Keep moving. You know what
my
saying?
Nigga went from fucking niggas up in the hallways to fucking niggas up on the clothes, man. Come on.
On the runways. You said the transition smoother, bro.
Come on, man.
That
would
have been a good.
Damn, man. Okay.
I was waiting on you to land that plane. I'm like, damn, Chief, you about to fuck him up, nigga.
Hey, shout out to the dope man.
Almost done counts. Hell yeah. I want to know this real quick. How did you develop your passion for clothing design, just in general? How did that come about? And did anybody inspire you?
I might have had some inspiration, but it definitely came when I was younger. Mm-hmm. I remember a time when back in school where when them little Alvisamar pictures were popping, you know what I'm saying?
Go like 2002.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
I used
to take all the pictures everybody gave and then put them on the shirt. Then I came to school and everybody liked their pictures, so I get them to sign on their shirt. Their picture. Mm-hmm. So now the shirt's starting to look like something, you know what I'm saying?
Right. So I like that.
Stuff like that, so I don't know. This shit just.
So you say around, let's say 2001, 2002. That's when everything started to click for you that...
Yeah, definitely high school.
Okay.
High school when everything started clicking off, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? The little Baby Nick came out. Mm-hmm. I couldn't afford Baby Nicks.
So nobody could.
I went to the store and got the glue that, you know what I'm saying, that looks the little shiny glue.
The glitter glue.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Then I put it on the shoes. Yeah.
He hit them with the Crayola.
You know what I'm saying?
Ain't nothing wrong with it.
Yeah, I'm trying to tell you. I only get one wear out of it, though, because after that, it's cracking up.
Can't wash it.
But it looked good, though.
For that time you wear it, you fly as fuck.
I'm telling you.
Huh, man.
So let me ask you this. Do you have a favorite garment to design?
Hats. I like doing hats.
Okay.
Yeah, I like doing hats. Hats is good because it's not a size thing. Mm. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Everybody can wear a hat.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? A baby can wear a hat. You know what I'm saying? So if I put a certain swag on a hat, it's easier to get it off then.
Okay.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you had to pick, you say hats, right?
Mm-hmm.
What style of hat? I like, I'm loving bucket hats now because I'm finally running across some made for black people with locks.
Right.
That was not a thing for a long time.
I got a couple for you. I need you.
Yeah, so do we go bucket hats? Do we go, I got a vise on for the first time, you know what I mean? And
I fuck with the fitted.
Okay.
Do we go fitted?
I don't got fitted. I got truckers.
Trucker hats. What about the soft?
Beanie.
I be having beanies.
Well, a trucker hat and a dad hat, that's kind of...
Nah, that's two different.
Okay, the trucker hat got this the mesh.
Right, there you go. Got the meshy on the back.
And the dad hat is soft. It's all soft.
Right.
Yeah, pretty much.
Right, but those are the ones, the dad hats.
Yeah.
The dad hats are the ones, you know.
Okay.
Wow. Everybody loves the dad hats.
I like the dad hats.
Yeah.
I like my Alley-Oop Television dad hat. And check us out on Alley-Oop Television.
For sure.
Crazy numbers. Actually, side note, people, I was so excited to get into this. While we've been gone, life has been life into the fullest, and we've been living it how we always do. So check out this clip. Right here, I did a video for a real entertaining, a real dope musician in the DMV. He goes by the name of Tay. So check out this clip right here. We shot that at the music department, you know, so that was a real quick video. Also did another one for...
Shout out Richie Rich.
Shout him out. I did another one for a guy by the name of Big Bills. I want to drop that clip 2. Check this clip out.
My dough rising like yeast, ain't it? My power level rising like I'm training with beasts, ain't it? It's looking like my dream ain't out of my reach, ain't it? And anybody standing in my way getting cheese grated. Death to each hater. I look up in the mirror and see greatness. And anybody say I ain't the one that he's hating. So fuck 2020 vision. I see Matrix code and gold records to my old school peach bang.
So darn fast.
Yeah.
You know what was crazy? Everybody that you just named is Suitland alumni.
Man, that's amazing, isn't it?
That's crazy. From Rich,
this
nigga Bills, nigga Tone Killian, us, but just not
Baby Bop.
Nigga, I went to Suitland too. That's not in the same year.
Not in the same generation.
Okay, but now that's even better though. You still Suitland.
Yeah, that's lit.
Alright, in some year.
I forgot that too.
Yeah, Suitland doing good though. Okay. Suitland doing real good.
See, you should have said that the first time.
Suitland doing real good.
Why didn't you say that the first
time? He's special.
Because I wasn't in the same year as y'all.
Remember what we have to say. His syndrome brings him down.
Oh man.
It's not about you. You gotta watch it. All right. could you tell us about your creative process when you design clothes? Like, what's the first thing that you see?
Like what I do?
What do you do? Is it on paper? Is it on the clothes physically?
It'd be like. Pause.
Bam! What's going on, good people? Your boy James Jones, man. I ain't here to talk about nothing. Y'all see it? You see it? What you say? Live from the South Side, right? Bam! Coffee mug. Live from the South Side. Bam! Stress ball. Bam! Lighter, live from the South Side.
That's what you gotta do it, niggas.
Possibly no way to do that.
Right. That's how they do it when you first get high at one of your jobs. You know what I mean? For the first time, like the first time ever. And you're walking back into your job and you're smacked out of your head. The first thing you should tell yourself is shake the high off.
No, this is like when you find out your mans and them work at the same job as you.
That's not a bad thing, nigga.
That's what I'm saying. Oh, you was talking about a bad. See, this is why we shouldn't smoke, man.
Man, whatever, man. We didn't do anything, people. We just took a break, and now we're back.
Hold up.
Welcome back to Live from the South Side. We're still with our amazing guest. You know, I was thinking about something,
yeah,
right?
He ain't Rick Ross us yet.
No, he didn't Rick Ross us yet. Shout outs to our last clothing designer that was here.
Hey, Mo, real shit, bro. The nigga came through. Nigga had a broad with him. Real life. I asked this, hey Mo, real shit. I asked, that was the nigga I was talking about. That was talking about the ghillie shit.
Okay.
Same motherfucker. I asked this nigga a question, like, real shit. Hey man, what y'all think about red cups?
What'd
he say?
This
nigga was like, well shit, I don't know about red cups, but I just bought this fucking Dodge Challenger, Mo. Do y'all fuck with the, like, what the fuck? I ain't got nothing. I'ma
be more specific. I'ma be more specific. His actual reply was, he said, you asked him like, asking me about the red cups. Go ahead.
Hey, Mo, what you think about these red cups, bro?
Huh? Red cups? I don't know, man. But, hey, man, tell me what y'all think about. Do you think girls got to pay for some stuff?
He said, how y'all feel about going 50-50 on bills? I was like, what?
And that's Shorty, exactly how
Shorty got up. Pissed off. That pissed her. Y'all couldn't see that off camera for those who remember that episode.
She was heated.
She was mad and wouldn't shut the fuck up.
Dog, that shit was terrible.
And
this
look,
nigga goes to drop her off.
And never came back.
I thought she killed him.
He's like, yeah, I'm just going down the street. Like, yeah, damn, son.
Shit probably got bad.
Yeah.
So quick. You still here, so that's clearly a good thing.
Right. Clearly a good thing.
Unless you want to leave.
I mean, I'm cool.
So if you want to leave, get the fuck on. Just go now.
I'm cool.
Don't lie to me.
We got hot 15, 20 minutes.
Right, yeah, right. Hell yeah.
There it
is. So I wanted to know this. We all believe in God, right?
Right.
We're not like... you're not like super into the Bible, but you believe in God and shit.
Yeah.
All right. So, now, my question, right? We know that there's a God. We believe in it and a higher being and shit. We read these stories from the Bible, right? How can we have these so-called accurate stories from the Bible and we can't explain stories like the pyramids? Now, the Bible
That's a good question.
You see what I mean? Like, the Bible is so accurate about the depictions of what's taking place, and he walked this way and led these people, this many people, and then fed this many from this. And I'm not discrediting any of that.
You gotta remember, they try to erase that part of history. They try to cut the nose off of the, what was it? The Sphinx?
Sphinx, yeah.
The Sphinx. They cut the nose off so you can't identify which, if it's race a black it was, person
right.
or a white person.
They said it looked like a Negro nose. So that's the crazy. White people, the settlers, they took that. And they also stripped the outer layer of the pyramid. It used to be coated in some type of almost diamond.
Yeah, they tried to get rid of all that.
Diamond coating, especially at the top. They said the top. Well, from what I hear, the pyramid, some people say it's a coliseum and all we've undug is the top. The other thing that I hear is the pyramid is actually a replica from the top. It's the same at the bottom. And yes. the glow from the light that used to be a diamond that they stripped off a lot of years ago, that used to reflect directly to the bottom. And that's how they lit the inside of the pyramid. That's why they say people like Ra could bring light at nighttime. Back in that day, because he used these type of diamonds to reflect the moonlight so brightly that it illuminated the night sky. So it's like different theories on the pyramid, but how did they get here? We don't have any accurate stories, and no one can accurately tell us anything. You see what I mean? But they can't tell us about the Bible.
Again, this is why we shouldn't smoke during breaks. What? No, I'm lost like a motherfucker. I ain't gonna hold you, okay? Yeah. We all family here. Yeah. I am lost like shit, bro.
Yeah, I'm definitely with you.
I'm not crazy, right?
Nah, I'm with you. I know what you're saying.
Okay, and we...
I was trying to... Look, I'm way too lit for this.
I'm just saying, man.
So right. You saying what's at the bottom of the pyramid?
This
I didn't ask that. You are
high. You said something about the pyramid.
You stopped
right. It was like a point, and it pointed with the light.
Right.
Something like
so
that.
So the light made the pyramid?
No, you're high.
Hey, bro.
Just rewind it back.
Fuck
that's
shit.
All I'm going to say. Moving on. So we left off at a good place. How do you incorporate diversity in your clothing? Now, I ask that because we're in a new era, a new trying time. I can't say people are sensitive, but people are hyper aware of every single move, every single thing you do.
Right.
And with a clothing brand like yours that's taking off, you're around a lot of people, you're shaking a lot of different hands, all types of people. How do you keep your clothes all inclusive? Because I've seen everybody, every lifestyle rock your shit.
I mean, I think it's just all in the name, you know what I'm saying? Because it's called United Society.
Hello.
So we're trying to unite society, you know what I'm saying? So it's not really, it's no barriers there. So, you know, us stands for us as people, as one, as people that's trying to, you know, come together and be about positivity. So, you know, that I guess that's how it really, like, meshes with everybody.
I like that.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let me ask you this. As a vicious-ass fashion designer... If you could collab with any other designer, who would it be? Your dream collab.
Damn, that's a good question.
Well, I guess, first of all, do you have a dream collab?
I mean, do I like people's clothes? Yeah. Right, I like Ron Bass. Ron Bass, he was like that. Like, yeah,
alright, so for the people like who don't know who that is, can you break it down a little bit? Because
I personally don't know everything about him, but I just like when he came out and what he got. You know what I'm saying? His designs and how he do stuff.
What type of style is it?
I seen him do this leather jacket from scratch. Like, he painted it at a little gallery or something he had.
Oh, nice.
It was epic. So I mean, he liked it. Ron Bass.
Okay. Know?
Mm-hmm.
So a Ron Bass United Society collab.
Man.
Okay.
That'd be Ron Us.
No, I like that.
Now is he a Negro?
Yeah, he's a black dude.
Okay.
Oh shit. Okay, yeah, I didn't think that.
Yeah,
let's
black
keep
dude.
It in the skin tone. That's what I'm talking
right.
about.
Yeah, so definitely.
Shout out to him. Tone. Okay, that's him?
Yeah, that's him right there.
Okay, do you know where he's from?
Not necessarily, nah. I just...
But you just got some good shit?
It's a little swag and everything he got going on.
He from New York. Brooklyn,
yeah.
New York.
Okay.
All
right, dude's coming through with the facts. I like that.
Yeah. Like, shit.
Hell yeah.
So if you could bring back any clothing joint, what would it be?
What? I like any
Brandon's not around. Not around. Ooh. I got two.
No, just
I'm gonna say Makunu.
Oh,
I like Makunu.
Oh, he got local. Yeah.
Listen, okay. I like them. You know, okay, because you know, coming up in high school, that's what I was wearing was you know the street brand. So
yeah,
right.
Makunu was one. Yeah, okay. I like Makunu.
Just
that
one.
Shit.
Who you got?
I say Shooters.
Shooters.
They still around though.
Yeah.
Yeah, but don't they nobody wear Shooters.
Yeah. I mean, they got a whole store though. They got a whole store. And they
shout out to Shooters. Shout out to Shooters.
Nah, they still around. They definitely. Yeah, nah, they definitely still booming.
Yeah,
it's. I got a whole store over there. They still okay. Yeah, they still just like we all won. They still around. They still doing good.
Right.
Well, they got whole stores. Shit's still flooded.
Damn.
I know.
This Saviato
every day.
Nah, hell no. Saviato still busting. And they still busting heads for their prices and their shit ain't even all that. But I mean, we ain't gonna go that way. We ain't gonna go that way. But right. Yeah.
But this is us. That's all that matters. You know what I mean?
I say
yeah, us.
If, definitely if I could bring level. If I could bring back any joint, it'll be LRG.
Okay. Y'all yeah, I did like LRG.
Whack.
Yeah. I like their.
Oh.
I did like their.
Okay. Well,
I like LRG.
But just because it ain't Geranimals.
Right.
Damn, you
baby shop. Baby shop.
No, no, what's a Geranimals?
That's a baby clothing line.
Oh, okay. I ain't even know.
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
Strictly for babies.
Yeah, and it's for transgender babies.
Oh, wow.
Well, Target is releasing it. Yeah. What?
You see, what? You always got
it is
to go
what it is.
With it. Come on, man.
It's facts, though.
Come on, man. They ain't got nothing to do with that.
Did they not have a transgender line for babies?
Man, pause.
I'm not sure.
We'll be right back after this motherfucker.
But they did. I support it if that's what they got going on.
Yeah, hold up.
Hold
up. Right. Right. That's all that matters.
But, I mean, I don't know.
Are there, because it's people out here that is designer clothes, and I know they have their go-tos, you know what I mean? Like, I like watching Trinidad James, you know what I mean? He's super interesting, shoot collections is crazy, so he has a clothing line.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing that he does that kind of separates himself from every type of designer that I've, like, seen so far, and I can't wait till his clothes get big enough to wear I can buy some, is he uses, and it's probably stupid, but he puts a see-through something on every piece of something that he has. A shirt, pants, shoes.
Okay. That's his tag.
That's his thing, you know what I mean? So I seen like a dress shirt and it had like a see-through like on the side of it. And then I seen like another shirt that had like a see-through pocket. It's just little shit like that. I like it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's about
so it. I could always kind of spot his clothes when I see somebody wearing it. And I know, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And it ain't for everybody to know, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So if you know fashion, if you know clothes and you into that, I'm into the hype beast shit a lot, you know what I mean? And
right.
This is definitely hype beast to me, you know what I mean?
That's
so,
a fact.
You know what I mean? So if you know type shit. So with that being said, what is something that you incorporate? Are there any fabrics or any textures or anything that you incorporate into your clothes that make it extremely unique?
Right. I don't know. I don't have like a certain thing that I do like that makes it. I mean, I just put the tag on it, so that's how you know. Boom, boom. But I don't have nothing certain that I do like that though. Mm-hmm. Nah, I don't.
So well, the tag. Once you see the tag, you know what it is.
Right. Once you put the logo on there, stamp.
Mm-hmm.
But I do. I am trying to like find a way to get out of that, so you can just see it, like how you saying. You know what I'm saying. That is good, but don't got one yet, nah.
I will say you do have one, and I will piggyback off what you said.
Talk
if I could. The tag, you know what I mean? The tag. I see this tag from a mile away. Right. I know exactly who that is. I know what it represents. I know where it's from. I can say, hey, I got some now, you know what I mean? But before it was, hey, I know that. I know that person, you know what I mean? And your tag is everything. And to me, your tag is like the bat signal. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And when I say that, it's not Michael Keaton. It's not this person or that person. It's the symbol itself. You see what I mean?
Right.
So let's say, Lord forbid, knock on wood or anything else, something may happen. You know what I mean? This is a symbol that could be represented forever. You
right.
See what I mean?
Yeah, I'm with you.
And it's something that I could see in the night sky. You know what I mean? So right. It's like, it's like the bat signal to me.
Nah, you're right. So I put the reflector on it. It be buzzing.
Bussing. It's something like that. So the tag, to me is definitely something that I see that you have that makes your shit stand out from everybody else that I see. You know what I mean?
It's all in the logo.
It's all in the logo. So what made you choose this for logo? Like, what were you going through? Like, what was in your head when you started designing this shit? Like, what was you thinking?
Man, shit, whole time, that shit, it was a group effort. Mm-hmm. I ain't gonna hold you. Niggas was spitting ideas. We got a little group chat that we had and shit. We was looking for a name, mm-hmm. looking for, you know what I'm saying, a brand logo, boom, boom, and we spitballing ideas. And we went through the text and tweaked it a little bit and came up with us.
So this is, so you got a team.
Yeah, it is. It's a team of us. Yeah,
you better shout your team out. Shout them out. He the only one doing the shit.
It's us, baby.
You got a whole team. You better shout them
niggas out. I'm trying to tell you, my man.
Shout all them niggas out.
My man, Keefe definitely be holding it down for shit, yo. Hold up, I'm talking about Look. B-Money. I'm about to call my son and shit. My son do rap this shit. Yeah, B-Money, my son. B-Money. Shout out to B-Money. Yeah. Hell yeah, bro. My nigga Be Easy definitely is us. Hell yeah. My man Draco.
Me
Gutta. Right. Swanells.
Hold on, is this a game?
Right, I'm about to say. I'm about to say, hold on. We ain't about to get indicted on this motherfucker. I ain't heard of Jason. I ain't heard of Steven.
Nah,
a Mike. I ain't heard nothing.
My man Kenny said, Black. Okay. Black definitely is
okay,
us,
shout out to them.
We definitely be in the building.
Kill him 100 bodies.
Like,
stab him in the stomach.
Little Percocet.
Right. What? Nigga, who are you naming? These felons do not. Are they working? Like, are they robbing? But nah, shout out to you fellas, man. And you guys came together. I would assume you're all young Black brothers, right?
Yeah, hell yeah, yeah.
It's amazing what you created.
Yeah, we all
you
know pursuing. Six out of eight of us is from Suitland.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a lot of y'all.
Man,
God
shout
damn.
Out to all y'all, man. Yeah.
Shout outs to y'all.
Whole time, yeah. I'm thinking it's just this nigga.
How about that?
It's us, baby.
It's us. It's, like he's, you know it's saying? Us, nah, that's never them. That's amazing. That's fucking though. Amazing.
Let me ask you this: top three things not to do as a fashion designer.
Damn, top three things not to do.
Not to do, nigga. Mm, you don't want to do this.
Don't want to do a bad drop. You don't want to do a bad drop.
Do a bad drop. What you mean?
Meaning like, you think something's gonna be fire and it don't be fire, or it's not gonna sell. I hadn't thought it was gonna sell. Okay. I mean, you can't really predict the future.
I was just about to say, how you gonna know?
You know what I'm saying? But that's, you don't want to. You don't want, that's one thing you don't want to do.
Okay, so all right. Yeah. Don't make no fucked up shit. No right. bad drops. Okay. Second thing.
You don't want to have the wrong manufacturer.
Ooh.
Definitely don't want to deal with the wrong manufacturer.
Let's speak about that real quick. All what right. What are some of the problems you can have by, because a lot of niggas, they just watching this, watching. They need to really right. understand this. What are some problems you can have by having the wrong manufacturer?
Mm-hmm. Small arms.
Oh Lord, slightly irregular. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh my God! He said small arms.
You know what I'm saying? Small waist. You know what I'm saying? God, everything damn. Come up good, but when you try to hit it, man,
it's can't put
tight,
it on.
You know? Damn, this joint tight as shit. On
one leg longer than the other.
Oh man, slightly irregular.
Right, you know slightly saying? Irregular.
Damn,
it's a little bit different.
Definitely, you know what I'm saying? Definitely can run into some issues.
What about timing? Like, if you need something, then do they be dragging their feet?
When you deal with somebody across seas, you definitely got to put some time on it.
Oh, that's what I fix, see? Okay.
You know what I'm saying? You don't want to say and think they're going to do something within a timely manner, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, they put your shit on the back,
yeah, they
like shit.
And you got to go in box, so, you know what I'm saying? You got to go in box so it can make sense. So. But, you know, that's why I do the customs too, so.
Mm-hmm. Say, shirt ready, 10 minutes. Shirt ready, 10 minutes.
A bit of your 3 months. 3 months.
Right.
Okay, so you got.
I can say 3 months. I give you like 1 month.
Oh, man.
Yeah, give you a month.
Nah, so, Corona, I know, slowed all that shit down, nigga. Course. But you was yes. booming in Corona, everything. Though. So I'm going to give it to this nigga was busting heads in Corona. I seen this nigga everywhere in the goddamn world. I told him first time I seen this nigga, I keep it real. Everybody know I do. I don't lie about nothing. The first time I see this nigga, I say, damn, nigga, to me, you only live on Instagram, nigga. I be seeing your ass everywhere.
I don't try to fucking say.
So hold up. So you got, don't put out no fucked up shit, no bad drops.
No bad drops.
You got to make sure you got a solid manufacturer.
Solid man.
And what's the last thing not to do as a fashion designer?
Not to do as a fashion designer.
I would say don't bite off another design or another designer.
Okay, yeah, that's one.
Don't copy.
Yeah, that's a good one. Don't copy.
Don't copy.
Don't copy. Don't copy.
Stay original.
See, I don't even do that. So,
but you can't say that because I just said that.
I couldn't even think of it. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't even think of it. All right.
I wasn't thinking about an answer, but if I had to come up with an answer, I would say something to the effect of don't promise people shit and you can't get it to them when they want it. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I think that's a major thing.
Lord, bro, what would you say?
People get pissed off.
Fast.
Them Yelp reviews is real.
Yep. Right. And you can lose your best client just like, and you don't know who your best client is. You see what I'm saying? It could be anybody. So treat them all good. Your best client could be the person that buy that one thing that one time, but they just trying to test you out, see how you are.
Like
after that nigga.
Bro, one thing.
One thing, little bro. What you
one
got?
One thing.
One thing.
To not do. Yeah, you shouldn't do.
You a clothing designer.
I don't know. Y'all like touch all bases.
I got a couple more. I mean,
hold up. Nothing, little bro?
I would like to hear these things.
Yeah, true.
Nothing at all? What?
We going to come back to you.
Because
think
of
something.
I had some me personally, I had some like bullshit. It's like I make a custom hat for this one person. I'd be like, all right, meet me Monday. We go on link and then I'm going to serve you the hat type shit. They don't pull up or they make up an excuse. All right, next Monday, we can pull up. Get the hat, so you could get the hat type shit and you still don't pull up. So now I'm just holding on to a hat that I made for you personally.
So it sounds like for you it would be
broke
secure
clients.
Secure the payment.
Secure the payment. I thought it was broke clients. You let me know what you think.
Cause you ain't gonna know a motherfucker broke.
Because
a motherfucker look like money and be broke as a motherfucker.
Liable customers. No, I know what a nigga broke.
Liable customers.
You ain't going to know what a nigga broke. A nigga
know what a nigga broke.
You know what I'm saying?
We are at the age where we know a nigga is broke.
Like, again, it just sounds like.
Could be fooling you, though, man.
Exactly.
All the way to the table.
Like, come on, man.
Yeah, they
all the way.
They had
you ain't
going to
know?
Oh, hold up. My camera.
I don't want to lose you. You mean everything to me.
And I don't want to lose you either, Jason, but we got to work better, harder, make a better effort if we want to make this relationship work.
You know there's something I've been wanting to do with you for a while now.
Really? What's that?
Securing the payment is good.
It be motherfuckers out.
Getting the payment up front is good.
Now, hear my logic, right? I hear secure the payment, right? Now, that is like fancy verbiage to me. Now, when you just break that down, if you're broke, how like, can you give the payment if you don't have the money to give?
Right, but but then that means that saves little bro some time because he ain't got to make the motherfucking shit.
Exactly. So you
and
should stop dealing with broke clients.
Whole time I ain't think they was broke because they had a clothing brand of themselves. So I was trying to do like a collab type shit, work with them.
He ain't even know.
Oh, look, you was telling the true story.
Yeah, that shit threw me off.
You want bullshit? All right, give me another one, Troop. I'll give you another one.
What?
Give me one more. I'll give you one more. We move on.
What? Now, I ain't no fucking fashion designer.
Well, it's just things not to do.
Oh, what? Of not to do.
Yeah. And then we get out of this. We get out of here.
Don't offend anybody.
Fuck that.
I was gonna say
anybody.
Fuck
them. Especially them alphabet peoples.
Yes.
Don't offend nobody with your clothing. Your clothing has to be universal.
Yes, it does.
From an 85-year-old white woman to a badass little black boy.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody should be able to wear these months. You know what I'm saying?
I agree.
For sure.
I agree.
I mean, that's true.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So what's yours?
I think that I can't help it, man.
Oh, man.
It's just right there. I was going to say, they keep adding alphabets, bro. Where do these alphabets stop? You know, it's something after.
Lord have mercy.
Is IA on the end now? Is after.
IA?
It's IA.
Yeah. Or is it AI?
No, it's IA. LGBTQIA. Plus
what?
The other letters are about to come. The other ones. There's more letters to come, bro.
It's gonna probably be a whole full alphabet, I believe.
And the kids are gonna learn their alphabets fucked up.
Hey, dog.
LBGT.
Oh my God.
My bad. All right, so.
Take it to another level. Right there.
You see what I'm saying? The habitual line stepper.
Hey.
No,
they keep adding them, bro. We gonna stop.
What was it again? What
LGBT.
Hey, no, y'all.
And like, that is not how that goes.
If the next letters rhyme, then they
it's a rap. It's a rap.
They
hey, dog.
If they start rhyming these joints, yeah, it's a rap.
It's a rap.
Dog.
Nah, we're going to get canceled.
Oh,
hey, is that, can we get into the updates?
Yes. Oh, all right, no, let's get into the updates, man.
Damn,
stupid as shit.
Live from the Southside Updates.
Chill. First up on Live from the Southside Updates, a service dog recently received a college diploma with his service person? I don't know. The dog named Justin apparently went to every class with Shawty and deserved the diploma just as much as she did. Now, all I have to say about this is if Justin can do it, there is no excuse for the rest of you bitches.
First of all, shout outs to us. But like I was saying, DDG wants you to try this new snack. It consists of a hot dog bun and ketchup. For all you glizzy lovers, we have the new ice glizzy. Literally, take the three biggest cubes of ice you can find, stuff them in a hot dog bun, and bite down as hard as you can. Just for you hard glizzy lovers.
Azealia Banks recently mocked the death of DC Young Fly's girlfriend by posting, "Dead at 32 on my 32nd birthday." But what she really meant to say is, "Dead at 32, just like my career, self-respect, and dental insurance."
Now, listen to this. Florida man arrested after robbing a phone repair shop with a cardboard box on his head. Now, you might not agree with me, but this was not the first thing I thought of when I heard putting your head in a box.
Next up on Live from the Southside Updates, seen here looking like everybody's ancestors is Teresa Nyaraka Jumba. And I probably fucked that all up. Now, she is allegedly 123 years old and is finally ready for love. Yikes. She said that she's never had a husband, but she's ready to let a nigga knock the stuffing off that molded McMuffin. Ah! She said, "I have never seen a man naked. I've had feelings for men when I was young, but I would never marry just any man. Let this be a lesson to all the women that's independent." She said she has lived with an unfulfilled wish, a rebellious hope, and a brave spirit, waiting for the day when someone will come and embrace her soul. Fortunately for her, there is somebody, but he comes with 12 disciples.
All right, so we're going to be ending Live from the Southside Updates with this update right here. And people, I wish I had something to go with this, but I just wanted to report it to you. Young Thug's brother, Un Funk, gets 9 years after violating probation after he snitched on Young Thug. Nigga, was it worth it?
Today's report. More than 75 million people are affected by the wildfires that's filling the streets of New York City with smoke. Now, with all that smoke, you could go rob that vending machine that had the crack pipes with no issues.
Live from the Southside Updates.
Chill.
I wanna know this before we wrap real quick. Are there any encouraging, inspiring words that you can give to the young clothing designers or just anybody in the clothing field right now?
Just keep going, man. You gotta, if you got something, you got a logo, you got a brand, you got a aspiration, just keep going. Don't stop. You know what I'm saying? Especially if everybody like showing you love and saying they like it. Mm-hmm. Don't stop it. Yeah,
I would say invest in yourself. You're going to run into people that probably are just not going to fuck with you. You're going to run into some people that's going to tell you they're going to pick up a hat this Monday, and then next Monday they tell you that they ran out of gas at the gas station. It's a whole bunch of stories they're going to give you. Yeah, you know what I mean? But I think through those times, you investing in yourself, staying down, believing in you, I think that'll help.
Mm-hmm. Shit, I think, be original. Stay original. I mean, I don't design clothes, but if I did, that would be the message. You know what? Fuck that. In anything you motherfuckers do, be original, man.
Yeah, that's how you stand out.
All day.
What you got? Make some fly shit.
I like it.
Make some shit everybody want to rock.
There it is.
No matter what age, what, you know, what bracket, what culture, you know?
Right.
get them words together. People, check us out.
Shout out to my man Steph Trail too. He's definitely us too, Steph Trail.
Oh, okay. Shout out. I forgot him earlier.
I did right. forget
I didn't Steph Trail.
I did forget him, but
yeah, he'd have been
Steph
the one.
Yeah, give your man Steph Trail.
Right.
He's definitely us.
How simple as that. But thank you for joining me, my nigga. Thank Real you so shit. Much.
Sure,
thank
hell
you.
Yeah,
man, like I said earlier, bro, I'm just glad to see the progression, my nigga.
Hell yeah, definitely.
No yes. bullshit. And I definitely appreciate you for not Rick Rossing us and leaving and not coming the fuck back.
Man, yeah. So check out his clothing. One more time, website.
It's usneverthem.com. usneverthem.com.
Yes, become a Live from the Southside podcast member as well. Go to livefromthesouthsidepodcast.com. Check us out on the Instagram, Live from the Southside Podcast. You know, hey, check us out on Alley-Oop Television.
And don't forget, all you rappers, please send your music portfolios to the fucking DM. Which DM?
Live from the Southside Podcast on Instagram.
Not DMV Trooper.
Also, like, comment, and subscribe.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, share this joint. Share this joint with a friend. You know, right. like I said,
please
remember.
Follow
remember.
Me on Instagram, too. ITSSSUSS.
There it is.
Yes. And remember, it's 6 degrees of separation. So, people, seriously, go to 6 of your closest friends. Show them this video. Show them this logo. Let them hear what we're talking about with this designer. And I guarantee you, one of your 6 friends knows this designer, have seen this logo. Watch what I'm talking about. It's going to shock the shit out of you. Like
That's
magic.
A fact.
I go by the name of Truth Teller Young Skills. That king right there, that is Trooper. The king you see in the back, that is Deuce. And the king that's joining us, this is Tone Calleon. Us, never them. We'll see you on the next one, people. Peace.
Truth Teller!